You know, if you don't believe in yourself, what you do, you never achieve nothing. I believe. My team believe me. And you all should believe in yourself, and you achieve what you want.
Hey, what's going on, ringsiders? This is your host, Boxing's Objective Observer, and welcome back to Ringside Stories. Feel free to subscribe, thumbs up, and hit that notification bell for the latest here on Ringside Stories. Thanks so much for your support in advance, and welcome to the channel. Dmitry Bivol has solidified his status as an elite-level boxer, coming off a career-defining win against the consensus pound-for-pound number one, Saul Canelo Alvarez.
Thank you, Canelo and his team. He's a great champion. I respect him. And thank you, Eddie, here. And sorry I broke your plans with Gennady Golovkin, maybe.
It takes two to tango. Maybe Team Canelo opts a different route, moving on from the Bivol rematch for now, because if Canelo moves back to the winner's bracket, Canelo versus Bivol 2 will be more intriguing if or when that rematch happens. Certainly in the case Dmitry Bivol stays undefeated and makes a few successful defenses of his WBA light heavyweight world title. At age 31, Bivol is in his fighting prime, who lives well outside of boxing and is a stylistic nightmare for Saul Canelo Alvarez. So in my opinion, a potential Canelo Bivol rematch will turn out exactly the same, even if that fight takes place at 168. So let's say the immediate rematch with Canelo Alvarez is off for now. What is next for the undefeated WBA 175 world champ Dmitry Bivol? Let us know in the comments below who you think Bivol should fight next. And assuming no crazy upsets happen in the near future, here are three possible opponents for Dmitry Bivol. Let's get into it. Number one, David Benavidez. Nicknamed El Bandera Roja, two-time super middleweight world champion and currently undefeated, who has been talked about as potentially the biggest threat at 168 for the man who has won that same WBC super middleweight world title, David Benavidez, never lost in the ring.
Everybody's talking about you, man.
Yeah, there's only one guy at that weight that can get an upset against Canelo, and that's a young man named David Benavidez. I had him in camp sparring with Golovkin, or moving with Golovkin, I should say, at a very young age. I won't say how old, but he was very young. Probably the best sparring I ever had up there in Big Bear for Golovkin. It was easy for him. I'm not going to say he banged anybody, but it wasn't like he was getting outclassed. So if he's doing that back then, he's a much better fighter today.
However, last time Benavidez was stripped was because he exceeded the 168-pound limit. Add on the fact this wasn't the first time, and the fact David Benavidez has contested as high as cruiserweight, being in his mid-20s, Benavidez can make 175 comfortably. On top of that, he already got valuable experience under his belt.
Speaking of Bivol, like obviously yourself, you're still young in the game, you've got a lot to prove at your own weight, but would you like to mix it in the ring with him at some point?
Yeah, definitely. I feel like we sparred before. We had some great sparring sessions.
How'd that go?
Bivol, when I sparred him, you know, he was really just throwing the 1-2. It's a strong 1-2. He leaves, like, you seen when I sparred him, you know, body wide open and, you know, throw combinations, those land in there. So, I mean, I already know what's going to happen.
Most notable wins so far in David Benavidez's career include Forky Medina, who went the full distance with Sweet Hands Caleb Plant, and the then IBF 168 world champion Chunky, aka James DeGale, but who David Benavidez beat from pillar to post before stopping him in round 8. Romer Alexis Angulo, who challenged twice for a portion of the 168-pound world titles, but against Benavidez was pulled out after taking a beating for 10 rounds.
David Benavidez!
Unbelievable.
And Anthony the Dog Durrell, who held the WBC super middleweight world title twice. An explosive affair with Durrell, suffering a huge cut in round 6 before getting TKO'd in the 9th. David Benavidez is the first and only to stop veteran Anthony Durrell.
They're gonna stop the fight right now. That will do it! Great victory, yeah. Benavidez.
Benavidez is talented and seems to enjoy fighting, but has certainly outgrown the 168-pound division. So why not take a chance at 175? David Benavidez has size, reach, height, power, hand speed, and a fighting style that may give El Bandera Roja an edge over the likes of Dmitry Bivol.
And if I can't make those fights happen, I think it might be time to move up to 175, you know.
If David Benavidez does indeed move up to 175, then Bivol versus Benavidez would make for an intriguing matchup. Number 2. Artur Bieterbiev. Artur Bieterbiev is the unified light heavyweight champion of the world, 17 pro wins, 17 wins by way of stoppage. At the making of this episode, Bieterbiev is set to defend his WBC and IBF world titles against fellow champ and hard-hitting Joe Smith Jr. Although the Dagestani-born has been dropped a couple of times showing some defensive lapses, he is able to box a little bit, but most people know him for his action-packed fighting style, who shines up close and at mid-range, suffocating his opponents with educated pressure and deadly power shots. A man of few words outside the ring, however, once the first bell rings, Artur Bieterbiev is about his business. Dmitry Bivol may have had the more extensive amateur career, Bieterbiev certainly was more decorated. A two-time European amateur champion, as well as a world amateur champion, having fought the likes of countryman and later unified light heavyweight world champion Sergey Kovalev, as well as current heavyweights Michael Hunter and the undisputed cruiserweight world champion Oleksandr Usyk. Artur Bieterbiev has experience mixing it up with the big boys and is extremely physically strong. Bieterbiev's most notable wins so far, former IBF light heavyweight world champion Tavoris Cloud, who Bieterbiev dispatched of inside two rounds in what was Bieterbiev's sixth professional fight. Bieterbiev also stopped then undefeated WBC world champion Oleksandr Gvozdik, who after the Bieterbiev loss retired from boxing. And in late 2021, Artur Bieterbiev steamrolled former WBA interim titleist Marcus Brown.
And a right hand right behind it, and Marcus Brown will take a knee with Beterbiev all over him. Oh, yeah. And down he goes after a hard left uppercut.
As impressive as the Canada-based Russian has looked so far in his pro career, a matchup with Dmitry Bivol will certainly be Bieterbiev's toughest as of today.
Я открыт к любым этим поединкам, то есть я приветствую любой объединительный бой.
His latest fight with Saul Canelo Alvarez showcased Bivol's elite-level boxing skills, his supreme understanding of distance, movement, defense and counterpunch abilities, and fantastic fitness levels. Dmitry Bivol is highly skilled, the almost indifferent level of moxie, the dedication to his craft, his laser focus are all indicators of quality and the level Dmitry Bivol operates on. Even the pound-for-pound number one couldn't trouble, much less hurt, the current WBA light heavyweight champion of the world. Artur Bieterbiev, however, may pose a bigger threat to Bivol than Saul Canelo Alvarez. So if Bieterbiev versus Bivol happens, will Dmitry Bivol be able to control the fight, or can Bieterbiev close the gap and seriously test Bivol's defense? And most importantly, will this be a fight for all of the marbles, the historic significance, and the first undisputed light heavyweight world champion since Roy Jones Jr. in 2003? Time reveals all. Hopefully for us boxing fans, this will include the fight between Artur Bieterbiev and Dmitry Bivol in a civil war between two undefeated Russian world champions, Artur Bieterbiev and Dmitry Bivol. Number 3. Gilberto Ramirez has the same Mexican heritage as David Benavidez, standing at 6'2.5" with a 75-inch reach, does not only have similar dimensions, but actually prefers to fight in similar fashion as El Bandera Roja. Only difference is Ramirez's southpaw stance, hence the nickname Zurdo, which translates to lefty.
Zurdo Ramirez! Knockout number 29! He remains perfect in the light heavyweight division. And Gonzalez is out, his legs dancing back to the corner, but what a courageous performance by Udesky Gonzalez.
Like David Benavidez, a former world champion at super middleweight, currently undefeated, however, unlike David Benavidez, has actually moved up to light heavyweight, where Ramirez has been campaigning since April of 2019.
Yeah, and there he goes down, they'll wave it off immediately.
Ramirez as durable, as respectable power, and as awkward, kind of like a light heavyweight juggernaut, Joe Joyce. Zurdo's most notable wins include Roamer Alexis Angulo, who David Benavidez stopped in the 10th round, yet who Ramirez beat when Angulo was still undefeated. Former two-weight world champion Arthur Abraham, and Sullivan Barrera, who took Dmitry Bivol 12 rounds before getting stopped halfway through the final round. It has to be said, Barrera surely was not the same fighter when he fought Gilberto Ramirez, who knocked Barrera out inside 4 rounds. Ramirez has been a pro since 2009, yet doesn't have a standout win on his resume, which a win over Dmitry Bivol would be that standout win that Ramirez is lacking in his career right now. Ramirez is currently ranked in the top 4 in 3 of the 4 major sanctioning bodies and is likely to be Bivol's WBA mandatory challenger.
Ramirez has Dmitry Bivol on his mind.
You are now the mandatory for the belt that's held by Dmitry Bivol. I assume that's the fight that you want next.
Well, everyone knows I want Bivol. Stop branding. Make sure you sign the contract next time. I'm coming for you.
He has size and reach over Bivol, having sparred the likes of David Benavidez and Saul Canelo Alvarez. Gilberto Ramirez is confident in his abilities and could pose interesting challenges for Dmitry Bivol. So if Bivol sticks to his word by not facing Canelo in an immediate rematch, yet if for some reason the fight for undisputed supremacy at light heavyweight is not next, Dmitry Bivol against Gilberto Ramirez would be a good matchup, going up against an undefeated former world champion who comes to fight and likes to prove he can go all the way again, even at light heavyweight. These are my 3 suggestions. What are yours? Who would you like to see Dmitry Bivol in with next? Let us know in the comments below. If you enjoy more content like this and you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe, give a thumbs up, and hit that notification bell. It helps the channel out a lot, i.e. inspire us to make more quality content for y'all. As always, thank you so much for your support and welcome to Ringside Stories. Now, if you've done that already, you're amazing. We already know that you are the true undisputed world champion. Till next time, Ringsiders, this is your host, Boxing Objective Observer, Ringside Stories. Thanks for watching and have a legendary day.